可以哦。
And good morning, Facebook family.
Yes, good morning.
Good morning, Apostle Katrina. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, beautiful family.
There you are. I see you now, Apostle Katrina.
Hi, beautiful. Hello, Facebook land, Eagle Nation. Woo woo. Oh, look at you. Oh, you look so beautiful.
I know they do.
Praise God. That's awesome.
Okay. I Eagle Destiny.
She's coming in now.
Yeah, I need to make. Good afternoon. We are in Indiana. Just a few more minutes. This technology. Okay, I think we can start. Good afternoon, good afternoon. Welcome. Welcome, family and friends. I welcome you to 10 Indiana 2020 graduation celebration. Woo! We're celebrating dance and flags. This is a year that is unforgettable, 2020, for all of us. This year we experience and still experiencing a lot of uncertainties and challenges. This year is a year also of learning new things, especially technology. This year is a year of doing things in a new way that we have not done before. But God, our awesome and almighty God, made a way, made it happen for us to persevere and push through in spite of what's going on around us. And we thank him for he made it possible for us to get here right now, at this moment. He makes something new, he makes something good, He is still performing miracles and giving us breakthrough. Anything can happen, for we all know how great our God is. And we will keep moving forward. Lord, we thank you for everything. We are excited and happy to share with you all this graduation celebration. Okay, now I have to move on with our celebration, and I have to do something for right now. Bear with me. Hold on. Okay, slash. And here we are. This is our 10, Indiana. And we are in Indianapolis. So we welcome you again to our 10 Indiana graduation celebration. And we are established in 2015. I am Cecilia Rush, the lead for EITI and 10. And I have co-leader for the dance, Reverend Dr. Eagle Charlene Phelps. And for the flag, co-leader Eagle Janetta Faison. So now, I think I did my welcome, right? We will continue on with our prayer, opening us up in prayer with Minister Ravi Terman and scripture reading with Eagle Samantha Tramer. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Good morning from Denver, Colorado. It's still morning where I am. It's 10:10 here in Denver. I just want to say thank you for giving me this opportunity. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come to your throne of grace, oh God. We come to you in the dance. We come to you in the flag. Lord God, we lift this up to you as a mighty incense unto you, Lord God. Let it be a sweet savor unto you, Lord. Father, it is all about you and not about ourselves, oh God. Father, guide our feet, Lord God. Father, guide our hands, Lord God. Father, let us worship you in spirit and in truth, Lord God. Even in this graduation, Lord God. Father God, we practice our steps. Father God, we have listened to the music. We have done all that we can do in preparation. Now, Lord, we want it to be unto you, Lord God. Father, guide our footsteps, Lord God. Father, guide our hands. I say it again. Father, guide our footsteps and guide our hands, Lord God. Father God, let this be pleasing unto you and only you. Father God, we thank you, Lord God, for this opportunity as well, Lord God. Father God, that we can worship you in this manner, Lord God. Father God, I thank you, Lord God, for the super extension of our worship. And we bless you today. In the matchless name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen. Colossians 3:16-17 reads, "Let the word of Christ live in you richly, flooding you with all wisdom. Apply the scriptures as you teach and instruct one another with the psalms and with festive praises and with prophetic songs given to you spontaneously by the Spirit. So sing to God with all your hearts. Let every activity of your lives and every word that comes from your lips be drenched with the beauty of our Lord Jesus, the Anointed One, and bring your constant praise to God, Father, because of what Christ has done for you. Amen, amen, amen."
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Now, let us get up, do our praise and worship. But the hour cometh, and now is when the time worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Seeketh such to worship him. John 4:23. Amen. All you guys on Facebook, you can join us wherever you are. Get up and just praise the Lord, for we are created to make his praise glorious. Amen. Yes, look at us. We are the living, breathing, walking, moving miracle. Whew, I need to get some water. Hallelujah. Praise him, praise him. For he is so worthy of our praise. We won't be here if it's not for God. Hallelujah. Well, now it is time to, I have to catch my breath. That was such a high praise. Okay, am I back on my slides? Yes. Okay, now it's time to introduce to most of you, but not us, because we know our Mama Eagle, the founder of Eagles International Training Institute. And if you hear EITI, that's how we refer that, EITI. She exemplifies servitude and she serves with humility. She encourages us to soar in excellence, all for the advancement of God's kingdom. She loves us so, so much and the nation. Yes, and we love her dearly. She is authentic. She is none other than Dr. Pamela Hardy. And after her, she will be followed by the director of Eagles, the Eagles Network. In short, 10. So when you hear 10, it's not the number 10. It's the Eagles Network. She is Apostle Katrina Butterflying Carter, a prophet and an apostle in her own right, who is tireless in providing 10 worldwide guidance, love, and praise. So let's hear from them.
Well, good morning, everyone. Good morning to the Eagle Nation. Good morning to 10 Worldwide. Good morning to Facebook family. I am Apostle Pamela Hardy. And it is so amazing to be with you all today. You look so beautiful. I just want to give God all the praise, all the glory, all the honor. You know, we might be having someone join us today who hasn't heard this story. And so for those of you who've heard it 500 times, you bear with me one more time. So I was on a plane traveling somewhere and the Lord told me to start the school. And so by the time the plane landed, he had given me everything for a Dance Year One. So when EITI started 15 years ago, come on somebody, give God praise for 15 years of soaring and serving. Woo! When the plane landed, I had everything. I told my husband, and our first year was just Dance Year One. That's all. We had 30 graduates our very first year, and I was so excited. I didn't know what was going on. I was still just trying to figure out, okay, Lord, what are we doing here? And so after that, the second year, we added a prophetic course and a business course. We had three courses. I'm like, wow, God, this is awesome. We have three courses. and after that, God just kept adding. And he's still adding 15 years later. So now we are an accredited school. Woo! We serve and soar in over 20 countries. You know, only the Lord could do that because I am from this little bitty town in Tennessee. I think we had one stoplight when I was growing up. So it's amazing to see what God has done. So now we have a school of theology, a school of business, and a school of the arts with over 20 different courses with amazing instructors. with everything from dance to the prophetic, to understanding leadership, to of course all the flags and pageantry. And then we study business. How do you start your business? And then we study the Bible, biblical foundations. There's just so many things that God has given us. So our mandate is to equip the saints for the work of the ministry. That's what God has called us to do according to Ephesians 4:11 and 12. So we have done our best to keep our eyes on the Lord. And as she said, advance the kingdom of God. So I'm on a plane again, traveling somewhere else. And I get this download, the Eagles Network, 10. Okay, what is that, Lord? What is that? So again, he downloaded, you know, his vision for 10. So EITI and 10 belongs to him. It's his vision. I always tell everybody, I'm not that smart. I could not have figured it out. It came straight from heaven. So whenever God gives you something to do, even if you don't understand it in the beginning, just do it. So now 10 is amazing. 10 has its own life, its own network, its own breath. We are one. However, 10, you know, as they say, teamwork makes the dream work. I knew I couldn't do it. I knew I needed some help. If you're smart, you'll get great people around you who know more than you know to help you. So God sent this amazing, beautiful lady who I don't know if she'll tell her story, but she came through Dance Your One. And then I remember looking at her, you know, and saying, don't make me come look for you, Apostle Katrina. Don't make me come look for you. I just knew there was something very special about her. And sure enough, she didn't. She stayed connected. And I want you to hear that. It's so important that you stay connected. The life is in the cluster, okay? You've seen a cluster of grapes. You can pick one grape off. But when you keep that grape in the cluster, it feeds all the rest. And so it's important that you stay connected, because through staying connected, the nations open. Through staying connected, your gift opens up. Through staying connected, you increase in vision. Through staying connected, you increase in revelation. Through staying connected, you have a family that's anywhere, just about anywhere you go in the world. You go to Africa, we have Eagles. You go to the UK, we have Eagles. You go to Holland, we have Eagles. You go to the Caribbean, we have Eagles. Just about anywhere you go, you're gonna find somebody that's a part of our family. Isn't that amazing? Woo! So, I want to give you this word. You know, this has been a year, right? Woo! When January 1st last year, none of us knew that this was going to take place. Oh my gosh. But you have persevered, you have pressed through. And what came to me when I asked the Lord what he wanted me to share was 1 Peter 2:9. You are a chosen generation. God has chosen you to survive in the midst of some terrible times. Not just survive, but thrive. And what he has for all of us going into 2021, 2021 is going to be spelled 20 and then W-O-N. Because we win. Amen. 2021, we win. But you are a chosen generation. He's chosen you. You're a royal priesthood. You're a holy nation. We are very special people so that we can proclaim his praises, the praises of him who's called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. So as a chosen one, this is a very special time, an appointed time that God had on his calendar from before the foundations of the earth. He had this time appointed for us. So you're not here by accident. He chose you, and you heard and you responded with a heart of obedience. So I want you in this season to raise your level of expectation, to understand that this is a time for miracles. This is the time where the light of God is going to shine bright in your situation. If you're in a season where you've been discouraged, be encouraged. If you're in a season where you're like, oh my gosh, this COVID is just too much for me, listen, put on that garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, because you are a chosen generation. So I just wanted to come by and say congratulations to all of the site leaders. Congratulations to all of the graduates. Congratulations to the assistants. Congratulations to everyone who has been a part of making 10 Indiana so special for the glory of God. God has great things planned. So again, in this season, keep your level of expectation raised up and just say, I'm chosen. God chose me for such a time as this. We know that Mary was for her generation, and Deborah was for her generation, and David was for his generation, and Moses was for his generation, but you are chosen for now. So now that you're graduating, woo, be excited, go forward, stay connected, continue to serve as we go into 2021. Come on in and join the EITI classes, but just know that you have a family that loves you very, very much. We do. And we look forward to seeing you guys, everybody, next year in Dallas. All roads lead to Dallas, October 2021. Woo! It's the last weekend in October. So don't miss it. Be here because we are going to have a great celebration. We thank God that we were able to do that this year through Zoom, and we reached so many people that we would not have been able to reach. So thank God for that. But we want to come together so we can hug and we can have our normal just family reunion. But it's not just open to Eagles and 10. If you're watching by Facebook, it's open to everyone. So connect with someone, whoever invited you here, and meet us in Dallas in October of 2021. So thank you again for having me here. It's been wonderful, even though we've had to have them through Zoom. Apostle Katrina and I always want to go to all the graduations. So we've gotten a chance to go to Trinidad and Ohio, and I think we're going, where are we going later today? We're going to Suriname, and tomorrow we're going to St. Vincent, and we just get to go to all the 10 graduations now and just give our love, tell you that we love you, say congratulations, let you know that you're part of a family that loves you, and don't forget, no matter what comes your way, you are chosen. God has chosen you for such a time as this. So if the enemy tries to come, just put your head up and say, but I'm chosen. Okay. And just know that as a chosen one, you have the victory. So grace and peace. Have a wonderful graduation. Enjoy the holiday season. Rejoice because God is good. He's a good God. He's a great God and greatly to be praised. So I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. And I love you. And I love you some more. So thank you, Cecilia, Eagle Cecilia. Thank you so much. And all of the 10 Indiana leaders, thank you for having me here, letting me stop in for a quick second. I love you much. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Dr. Apostle Pamela. Now, woo-hoo. Apostle Katrina.
Woo! Woo!
Let me see here one moment. Hallelujah. Oops, did I do it right? Am I there? All right, can you all see me okay?
We can see you really well and we can hear you good.
Oh, cool. Something weird happened. Okay. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Good morning, Eagle Nation.
Good morning.
Good morning, 10 Worldwide. Congratulations to all of our graduates. God bless you. We are so excited for you. You have persevered through so much this year and just have proven yourselves to be unstoppable. And we are so excited for you and the new that the Lord has for you. I am Apostle Katrina Carter, the Butterflying. And it's such an honor to serve in God's kingdom. It's such an honor to serve in 10 Worldwide as your 10 team director. I honor our leadership, our founder, Apostle Dr. Pamela Hardy, this morning, because I could not have asked for a better partner. I feel spoiled at times because she's so awesome. And you'll see an example of what I mean in just a minute. But I just praise God for her entrusting this precious, precious vision to me. It's such an honor. I don't take it lightly. And it's such a joy and just humbling experience to be able to serve. I never knew that 10 Worldwide was a thing, right? It was a movement. I never knew that the Lord would call me to such a place and such a service and time as this. I was 10 graduates. I started out right where you are as a 10 graduate back in 2012, 2011. And I was shy. I was very afraid. I would not talk. I know that's unbelievable and quite hilarious, but it is true. I would refuse to speak. And the Lord sent an eagle after me in the spirit to activate me and stir up the gifts of God within me through 10 Worldwide, through Eagles International Training Institute. And the Lord said, hey, you're not just a dancer, you're a preacher. And I'm like, wait, what? And then he said, you're not just a dancer, you're a prophet. I'm like, wait, what? And then he said, you're not just a dancer, you're an apostle to the nations. And I'm like, okay. So and then he said, okay, I need you to write a book. I need you to equip my people and teach a class. And so it just goes on, right? So that is my encouragement to you all today is don't let today be the end. Right? But let it be the beginning to a beautiful, beautiful journey. And I stand as a living testimony that the Lord can do all things. He can do the new. He can do the seemingly impossible. Amen. Like I said, I never thought I would be sitting before you today. My first time on a plane, guys, was graduating from Eagles International. Flying to Texas. That was my first time on a plane. And then Apostle Pamela, I walked across the stage and she gave me a big old hug. And then she stopped me. She said, don't make me come looking for you. And I said, oh, yes, ma'am. And so then, so there's a requirement. We have to have our passports. We can't serve the nations without a passport, right? So then she messaged me, I want to say in like 2016, right in the beginning there. And she said, okay, I told you. Don't make me come looking for you. And I'm like, oh, yes, ma'am. So, and so then that was my first time serving internationally. And it's been an honor, an adventure. There's been so much growth and learning ever since. So I just pray that you're encouraged by my story. I love sharing my story because it was through the dance. It was through that place of worship that the Lord cultivated me and nurtured me into who I am and into who I am still yet becoming today. So I praise God for that. And the Bible declares that we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. So if you're out there, even to those on Facebook, if 10 Worldwide has impacted you, amen, share your testimony. Invite someone else to come to these modules. Invite someone else to register to graduate for EITI. Amen. And just keep serving, keep soaring, keep loving. Amen. And keep going by all means. Amen. Hallelujah. So 10 Worldwide is such an awesome network. We are established in nearing 30 nations. And we have several what are called clusters. For those of you who are visiting and don't know about us, we have clusters and we have 10 Dance Year 1, 10 Dance Year 2, 10 Corrigeo for dance leaders, 10 Mime, 10 Pageantry. That's the worship tools, the weaponry, amen. We have 10 Flags and new this year, 10 Flags Year 2. And we also have new this year, 10 Worship, hallelujah. And then the Lord is just breathing so heavily on our Spanish and Latina nations and our family there, hallelujah. And so we have had to form a new cluster for 10 Spanish, hallelujah. And then I feel like I'm leaving out one. Yes, and then we have something special because God desires all his worshipers to be able to be equipped and to serve him. And that includes the children, the babies. I have a special place in my heart for the babies. And we have our 10 Now Gen cluster, which is about 2 or 3 years old. And there's a phenomenal team, hallelujah. When the Lord called me to serve in 10, I met with Apostle Pamela and we huddled together and put our spirits and hearts together and prayed. And the Lord told us to restructure TIM Worldwide in teams. So we have apostolic teams, amen, all over the world. And I honor our 10 leadership team today. So all of those clusters I just named, we also have 10 leaders who serve as our board of directors, if you will. And so I honor them today. I love you all so much. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Now, here's the part when I said I love Apostle Pamela and our covenant, because the Lord gave to me a word for you all today. And it is also from 1 Peter 2:9. Amen. But and we haven't spoken other than we text each other to say, I love you. Good night. But we haven't spoken. So this is the power of covenant and the power of a supernatural bond. Tan and EITI, we are supernaturally connected. Amen. So this is what the Lord said. He said that now is our time to carry out 3 I's. The first one is he's sending us as initiators. And that speaks of causing an action or a process to begin. So in other words, he's saying as initiators, I'm sending you to build. Now is your time to build. 1 Peter 2:9 says, you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people that ye should show forth or initiate by showing forth the praises of him who has called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Amen. So now is your time to initiate and reveal and manifest who God is and who the kingdom is, what the kingdom is, all in the earth in your sphere of influence. Amen. Jeremiah 1:10, these are the initiators. He says, today I appoint you to stand up against nations and kingdoms. Some you must uproot and tear down, destroy and overthrow. Others you must build up and plant. So 10 graduates, 10 worldwide, now is our time to initiate by building, to initiate by tearing down and overthrowing, to destroy. We don't wait for whatever comes. We go and initiate what we declare and what the kingdom mandates for us to happen in the earth. Amen. Hallelujah. The second thing is the Lord is saying he's releasing innovators. Innovators. Everybody hold your hands up. Hallelujah. To be an innovator or an innovation is the creation, development, and implementation of a new product, process, or service. Amen. It has the aim of improving efficiency, effectiveness, or competitive advantage by definition. Simply put, to be an innovator means to create something new. So look at your hands. The Lord says, now is your time to create. Now is your time to pull on the creative power of God, and he's put it in you in the Holy Spirit. He says, whatever I have set forth your hand to do, go forth and do it. I will cause it to succeed. I will cause you to prosper. I will cause it to multiply. So go ahead and utilize those hands and create. Hallelujah. So he's releasing you as innovators today. Deuteronomy 8:18 tells us, it says, but remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you the ability to produce. So being an innovator speaks of being a producer in the earth. Hallelujah. And he says, I'm giving you the ability to produce wealth. Amen. And so confirms his covenant, which he swore to your ancestors as it is today. So the Lord wants to confirm and reveal who he is through you. So go ahead and create that new business. Go ahead and write your new book. Go ahead and create that new garment for you seamstresses out there. Go ahead and create your new ministry or hub. Hallelujah. And sign up for Kingdom Spheres and KMT in the process. Hallelujah. Amen. And produce. We're not just consumers. Eagles, we are not just consumers. We are producers. We are contributors. Amen. So the Lord is saying, seek my face and just sit before me. I'm going to give you the strategy for new crafty innovation. Kingdom innovation is upon us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And the last thing he says is that I'm sending you as implementers. So now's your time to implement. You've been studying all year. You've graduated. Hallelujah. But he says, now is the time to implement the vision and implement what I've shown you. Now, an implementer, or to implement, speaks of putting into use. It speaks of execution. It speaks of enforcing. It speaks of performing a vision or performing a task. And it's the ability to carry through. And the Lord says, I've given you the ability to carry through. Philippians 1:6 says, being confident of this very thing, that he who has begun a good work in you will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. He will complete. He will cause you to carry through. Today, graduates, is your testament of that. Today is a manifestation of that, that the Lord shall see you through. And I'm even seeing, for those of you who are experiencing some turbulence in your life, that's what I call warfare, just a little turbulence. It'd be okay. But if you're experiencing turbulence, just stay in the face of the Lord and be encouraged. He will see you through. Hallelujah. He will see you through to success and favor. He will see you through to healing. He will see you through to restoration. So be encouraged in that. Amen. Also, as an implementer, it speaks of being a tool or a utensil in the hand of the Lord. Hallelujah. 2 Timothy 2:21 tells us, if you keep yourself pure, so there is a lifestyle of holiness, hallelujah, you will be a special utensil for honorable use. And that is what you have been prepared to be, a special utensil for honorable use. You are the implementers. So now is the time to initiate. Go, Apostle Pamela talked about being a firebrand. Firebrands are initiators. We go and ignite things. Amen. We go and activate things and bring it to life. Hallelujah. That's the initiator. So I send you as initiators. I send you as innovators. Hallelujah. You will have witty inventions, witty ideas to shift your nation, to shift Indiana, to shift the Midwest. I'm here in Ohio. So I believe the Lord wants us to come together once Lil Rona goes away, and begin to initiate some divine innovations. Amen. And then he says, I'm sending you as implementers. Don't just sit and wait around. Implement the vision. Carry it out. Amen. Yield yourself as a tool or a utensil that is fit and ready for God's use. And he says, you are fit. You are ready. You are well able. You're well able. Amen. So go forth and prosper. Go forth, be in good health. Go forth in the joy of the Lord, in the strength of the Lord, and carry out whichever one of these applies to you, which is really all of them. But go forth and be the manifested sons. Romans 8 tells us the earth is groaning and waiting for the manifestations of the sons of God, right? The NLT tells us that the earth is waiting for the sons of God to be revealed. So that word manifest speaks of revealing. Hallelujah. And so the Lord is saying for us to make this our decree. And if you're on Facebook, post this in the comments. For those of you who are here on Zoom, post it in the chat. The wait is over. The sons and daughters are arising. We are emerging. We're soaring. Hallelujah. The wait is over. World, wait no more, because the kingdom is here. We are established. We are forcefully advancing, and we are going forth as royal priests, and we are going forth as kings and priests in the earth. We're going forth to rule and to serve, to rule as dominionaires, but to serve as humble servants of the Lord, to serve in love, to serve in the supernatural, to serve through equipping ministry. Hallelujah. We are going. We're here now, and we're ready, and we're coming. The kingdom has come nigh. The kingdom has come nigh. God bless you. I love you all. Happy graduation day, and have a wonderful day. Love y'all.
Love you, love you, love you. Thank you, Dr. Pamela and Apostle Katrina, for the word. Thank you for your love and support. And most of all, thank you for gracing us your presence today, this very special day. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And since I am in thanking mode, allow me to say our thanks now before I get so excited and I forget. I don't want to do that though. So we as 10 Indiana would like to acknowledge and express our heartfelt thanks and gratitude first and foremost to our Most High God, because he makes this celebration possible. To God be the glory. And again, to Dr. Apostle Pamela and Apostle Katrina, we thank you again. I thank you. I am just so, so grateful. And also to our young adults, Eagle Destiny and Mr. Christopher Blunt, for their technical support. Amen. Eagle Destiny is such a great help. And Mr. Christopher, he's the one who videotaped us, pre-recorded our presentation, dance and flag presentation. And to our loving family and friends for their support. To our pastors, First Lady, and churches. To my pastor, Reverend Robert Harvey, and our First Lady, Mary Harvey, and to my church family, because New Zion Family Community Church, it all started there. They opened, they welcomed me, and they supported me, 10 Indiana. This is just the first time that we didn't do it there. So, and also thank you to Pastor and First Lady Tompkins for opening up their gymnasium, church gymnasium, of God's Grace Community Church. And to all of the 10 graduates, I love you all. And to all of you who joined us on Facebook, thank you, thank you, thank you. So now we will proceed to, are you seeing my slide? No? Yes? No? Maybe so? Oh, I got to, that's what I forgot. I got to share the screen. Amen. Okay. And before we proceed to our 10 graduates, I would just like to, I don't know. Are you seeing my slides? Yes? Okay. Like to congratulate our past 10 graduates who went on to graduate at the Eagles International Training Institute. Eagle Samantha Tramer, Dance Year 1, and Eagle Janetta Faison, Flag Year 2.
Woohoo!
Yes, we will share. Yes, we will share their final ministry piece. Amen. Oh, okay. Here we go. I know you'll be blessed.
God bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon you, be gracious to you, God turn his face toward you and give you. Thank you.
That was so amazing. I got tears in my eyes. Ego Samantha, Ego Johnny. Oh my gosh. You just blessed me. Whew. What a blessing indeed. And I know you've been blessed as well. So now it's time for us to introduce our 2020 10 Indiana graduates. And here we go. Reverend Dr. Charlene Phelps will do the honor.
Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. 10 Indianapolis Dance graduate of 2020. Hallelujah. Tanya Buford. Because of work and demands of work and whatnot, she's not able to be with us, but God bless her. She completed the course. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. 10 Indianapolis Dance graduate of 2020, Charlene Howard. Hallelujah. Thank you, God, for her perseverance. Hallelujah. Charlene Jr. God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah. 10 Indianapolis Dan graduate of 2020, Jasmine Lee. God bless her. She was not able to be with us. Hallelujah. Work and some other commitments, but God bless her. She finished the course. God bless you, Jasmine. Hallelujah. 10 Indianapolis Dance graduate of 2020, Beverly Perdue. Hallelujah. God bless her. She has some issues with her health. So she's not able to be with her, but God bless her. She persevered through it. She pushed through it. God bless her. Hallelujah. 10 Indianapolis Dance graduate of 2020, Stacy River Blount. Hallelujah. And her beautiful family, all their support. She did it, and she's now enrolled in EITI Dance Year One. So God bless you, Stacy. Hallelujah. Congratulations.
Now we will do the flag graduates, and we will be Eagle Janetta Payson.
Amen. Yes, 10 Indy flag graduates. Congratulations. Hallelujah. Our first graduate, the 10 Indianapolis flag graduate, Micah Housale. Congratulations. Next, we have Charlene Howard, 10 Indianapolis flag graduate. And the next 10 Indianapolis flag graduate, 2020, is Shaniqua Mills. Congratulations. Ten Indianapolis flag graduate, Beverly Perdue. Congratulations. Ten Indianapolis flag graduate, Stacy Rivers Blount. Congratulations. Ten Indianapolis flag graduate, Lynette Rock. Congratulations.
Now we're gonna have their testimony, five of them. And in case you're wondering, I've seen that picture before in dance. Why did I see it again in flags? We have three of them that did dance and flag the same time, the same year. And that is wonderful. Congratulations.
Hello, my name is Lynette Rock. I am a first year flag graduate of 10 Indiana. Praise God. 10 has impacted me spiritually and have empowered me to advance into this new ministry, to glorify God and to allow his light to shine through me for others to experience. I am so blessed to be under the direction and leadership of Eagle Cecilia Rush. Praise God. Thank you.
10 Training has given me an invaluable education. I knew that I wanted to use my gift of dance for the Lord, but it is an incredible asset to have the biblical background and scriptural references provided through our 10 lessons. Reverend Dr. Charlene and Eagle Cecilia, along with Eagle Johnny, have been wonderful in helping to educate us and also just sharing their testimonies. I've met some wonderful ladies and we've had an awesome experience fellowshipping with each other. It is definitely my responsibility to help educate those in my ministry so that we can further our reach and help to bring other dancers and other people to the Lord.
Grace and peace, everyone. Just want to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I want to thank 10s International. I want to thank 10s Indy. I want to thank the Hardings, Eagle Cecilia, Eagle Johnny, and Dr. Reverend Charlene, my prayer pack in Indy. I want to thank and praise all my sisters I had an opportunity to minister with and dance with. You've all been a blessing to me, and thank you so much. I just want to share a little bit about why 10's Indy has been such a blessing to me. I believe that I have this passion in me for praise and worship, and it's been laying dormant for many, many years. And it wasn't until I ran into Eagle Cecilia and Eagle Johnny and Dr. Reverend Charlene and Indy that that gift began to come alive. I just want to thank 10s International for starting something worldwide that has reached many, many states, even here in Indianapolis. Thank you so much. God is good. I thank God foremost before anyone for connecting me with all the people that I've connected with in this season. God bless you all. Good night.
Hi, my name is Shaniqua Mills. I am a graduate of 10 Indiana Flag 2020. I'm also a previous graduate of 10 Indiana Dance in 2017. The impact this ministry has had on my life is amazing. I love the fact that I was able to be a part of the two-day intensive LOLOM in Detroit, Michigan. That was a huge impact. That actually opened the door for me to advance, yes, forcefully into the kingdom. This ministry has done so many things for my life. It gives me an opportunity to continue to minister to people, whether it be through dance or through a spoken word. it has allowed me to grow deeper in God and to learn more of him and to worship him in spirit and in truth and to worship him along with so many others. I'm just so grateful and thankful to Eagle Cecilia Rush for being under her leadership for the past 3+ years. Just the fact that she demonstrates all those principles that come with being a member of 10. Excellence being one, patience, love, mostly love. I mean, it doesn't even matter. You know, we come to her with a concern, she just pours back love. All love. You might be expecting another answer. She's gonna give you love. So that has been a huge impact for me. I'm just grateful and thankful to be a part of 10 Eagles. I look forward to assisting her in 2021 as being her assistant. And also, I'm looking very forward to becoming an Eagle myself. Thank you.
Being a part of 10 has truly been a blessing. I've learned so much in the dance and the flag classes, just been able to research the words, to know that the different meaning of the colors, the importance of dance, the importance of flags, and how it truly impacts a ministry. Just being able to know that what I am doing for God really has a purpose, that it has a meaning, that it is truly, truly a ministry. And it's not just going out looking pretty, going out just, oh, I'm just going to dance this and be done with it. No, it is truly, truly a ministry to know that in a way how I am impacting people's lives, how just my dance, my movements can influence someone to like, oh my goodness, God is truly speaking that way, not just, you know, the preacher, not just an evangelist, but to actually know during dance, doing flags, that the words that are being spoken but not spoken, to know that how much you can touch somebody's heart and all of that, and to be able to know that what you are doing lines up with the word of God. And it's like, it's truly have been amazing. It's truly been a blessing to open up the word and be like, oh, wow, there were dancers in the beginning, and to know that I am called to these ministries as truly blessed, and to be able to come with other dancers and worshipers, not knowing before when I was growing up what was my purpose, to know that this is who I am in Christ. And it has been an awesome, awesome, an amazing opportunity. And I just cannot wait to continue going the road that God has set for me.
Okay, hallelujah. Impact of 10 to all the students. Amen. Now we're just going to show you some more pictures. Pictures of them. And smile. Here we are. Okay. We were supposed to have a little music here. Just sharing pictures and more pictures and their crown.
Okay. We love the pictures. We love the pictures.
And as part of their
love the pictures.
Part of their graduation is they have to do a ministry piece, a choreography, to show what they learned. So now we have one dance presentation and two flag presentation. So here we go.
I jumped up from the floor to the middle. Think I want the credit, I don't. Cause the glory speak my heart. So I fall to my knees and I say that I'm grateful for every morning stars. So I don't make my lucky stars. That's not where my blessings are. Where they come from, my father's heart. Not the sky, not the chance, but truth is, I'm not lucky.
Okay, I need to get out of this screen. Let me see. Because that's YouTube. It's not working this time. Technical difficulties on my part. Sorry. There we go. Eagle Johnny, your turn. Still learning. Are you there? Go, Johnny. Okay. Anyway. Now we are going to present to you the flags, students. First video will be Sister Shaniqua. I grouped them together, two or three. Sister Shaniqua Mills, Sister Lynette Rock, and Sister Micah Housel. And then it's going to be followed by, again, Sister Charlene Howard and Sister Stacy Rivers Blunt. Amen. Okay, let's go. Hallelujah.
See you.
Thank you. So in all of our graduation, we do a piece, a dance and flag of all the graduates, current and past graduates. So we will grace you with that. Amen. More pictures. Here we go. This is the dance one. Anything can happen in here. So now we will do the flag. Concludes our video presentation. So we are getting ready to close. We will have closing remarks and prayer by Eagle Janetta and Reverend Dr. Eagle Charlene Phelps. So can we pin them?
Yes.
Okay. One second. Okay, I have to. There you go.
Okay. All right. So it has been a wonderful, wonderful year. Just experiencing all the ladies. I just want to again thank Dr. Hardy for your vision and going forth and being obedient to God and allowing us a place in the worship area to have dance in the church, not only viewed as a worship tool, but not as in the world thinks of dance, but as it's thought of in the church as worship. And also allowing us to bring flags, which is my passion, into the church. So I also want to thank Apostle Katrina for being the director for 10. And we definitely want to get to Ohio to be with you. So praise the Lord. We want to connect that way. We thank you for our leader, Eagle Cecilia, for all her patience and her directions, her guidance, her wisdom. Thank you so much. And to the ladies, I want to say thank you so much for pressing through. We know that it's been definitely a test trying to do flags in the house with a ceiling above your head in a box in the closet, trying to extend your arms, and you hear me saying no elbows, and you're still like, but I don't have anywhere, and you're doing a washing machine move. But we thank you for not giving up and to continue to move forward. And I pray that those of you who have not decided to move forward and being an Eagle, that you will use your time to pray and get confirmation from God into where you're going to go from this point on and join the Eagle Nation, preferably Flags, but you know, I'll take something else if it's dance, I suppose. No, I'm teasing, but please join the Eagle Nation. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And I will pass it on to Reverend Dr. Charlene Quad. She's on her way to the fifth Eagle class. So we call her Reverend Dr. Charlene Eagle Quad.
Amen. I thank God. I thank God. God is so faithful. He's proven himself over and over again. And I'm so grateful to be a part of this and assist Miss Cecilia. Thank you, Miss Cecilia. Thank you, Dr. Hardy, for your vision and your pressing. I've been watching all of you guys, Apostle Katrina, and it really encourages me. Even during this season, I was like, wow, how are we going to do this? And I just have seen everyone's fortitude and just refusing to give up. Hallelujah. So I thank God for the graduates. Hallelujah. How you guys have not given up. Hallelujah. You just pressed in. You know, we prayed together. We prayed together and we prayed together. And I just bless all of you guys. So let's close in prayer. Amen. So dear Lord, we thank you, hallelujah, for this opportunity to worship you. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord, that you kept us. Hallelujah, Lord God. Thank you, Lord, that you encouraged us, Lord God. I pray for each graduate, Lord God, that you would just shine your face on them, that you would speak to them in the midnight hour, Lord God. Whisper to them, Lord God. Give them direction, Lord God. Hallelujah. You have a special plan and purpose for each one of them, Lord God. Hallelujah. So we release them today, hallelujah, into your hands, hallelujah, so that you can hallelujah, put them on your table and just mold them and shape them the way they need to be shaped. Hallelujah. Lord, continue to just fill them with your Holy Spirit, Lord God. Hallelujah. We just bless them, encourage them, all in your name, Jesus, we pray. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Okay. Let's see. What's next? Aren't you going to tell me something? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can. One more thing. There is a bag sitting somewhere near you. Could you please open that up? That is for a gift from the class of 2020 Dance and Flags.
Okay. Hallelujah.
Woo-hoo!
I got this yesterday, but I didn't do anything. I just put it on the side. So I will be opening this up. My goodness. Oh, goodness, goodness. My favorite chocolate candies. More chocolate candies. Okay. And I got cards. Do I need to open each one?
No, you don't have to.
I don't have to. I'll just open the big one then. Pretty. Apostle Katrina, purple. Oh, what is it? A flag bag. Woo! Look at that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, my goodness. I want to be like Eagle Johnny. She has an arsenal of flags and all kinds of worship tools. So I'm on my way, Eagle Johnny. Thank you, thank you. So now, am I still sharing screen? Let me see. Okay, we all gonna get up. Are we gonna get up? I'm not sure. We are? We're going to get up, and what are we going to say? We are going, this is closing time.
Unmute, you guys, unmute.
Unmute yourself.
Mute.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Cecilia, great job, team.
We are Team Indiana. And forcefully, forcefully, we're established.
Indiana.
Established. And forcefully
established.
Yay!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah.
Love it.
Awesome.
I'm gonna stop now. Stop streaming.
Okay, we love you.
Love you, everybody. Thank you. Thank you for attending. Thank you.